The skin is so smooth, the hair and the eyes, well, lifelike, until you watch Dan Popa go to work.
Do you like robots?
Naturally, I love robots. It's my species.
Do you like humans?
That's funny.
Popa is the human here, having a conversation with a robot he created.
I do research in robotics.
Popa is an electrical and computer engineering professor at the University of Louisville. He and his robots came to UofL from Texas this year, bringing with them a big money grant from the National Science Foundation.
The project is about creating a next generation robot nurse assistants. And I stress assistants because these are not nurses, or they will not replace nurses, but they will essentially make nurses more productive. They will help them do their job better. And the patients will also benefit in the process.
Popa and his team are training robot prototypes like this one to respond to commands and learn repetitive motions so they could serve as 24-hour patient sitters, picking up gloves, fetching water, or helping a patient walk down a hospital hallway.
We can right now instruct the robot to find and grab a glass of water. It will be successful maybe 85% of the time, meaning that 15% of the time it will either drop the glass or knock off the glass, right? So in order for this to be deployed in a hospital or a home, it needs to be successful 99.9% of the time. So some of the research is focused on how do we actually increase that reliability to those kinds of levels.
They're also developing skin for the robots, which frankly feels a little creepy, but serves two purposes: a way to attach and hide sensors, and a way to make the robots look human.
If the robot looks like a child or like Albert Einstein or somebody who's been a positive figure in history, then people will be accepting. But if it looks like a nefarious character or a zombie or something like that, of course you're going to get repulsed. So appearance has something to do with it. I don't think people realize that this technology is very close to being deployed. I believe that within 5 to 10 years, you'll be going to the store, and buying a next appliance for your house, and that's going to be a robot. And then you're going to bring this appliance home, and you're going to teach it to do certain things that interest you.